Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is New Verse, New Year's Eve celebration praise party. We need you to tag, comment, and share. If you're ready to have a good time, make some noise in your homes. We're doing it virtually this year. Let's party. Clap your hands. If you remember this song, make some noise for me where you at right now. Sing it, sing it, sing it. One more time, let's go. Oh yes, it's a praise party today, tonight. We bringing in 2021 the right way.
Report to the dance floor. Report to the dance floor. Report to the dance floor. Step, step,
step. Hey.
Backstand still, matter of fact, shout. Everywhere you look, you got a blessing on the way. Step up. Backstand still, matter of fact, shout. Everywhere you look, you got a blessing on the way. Turn it out to the right. Clap, clap, step up and watch God. Step back and watch.
If you happy, glad that you made it through 2020 and you ready for 2021, make some noise for me right now. This is a party, ladies and gentlemen. Tag, come in and share. Dr. Brian, what's up? Welcome to New Birth. I'm so excited for 2021.
Hold up.
It's a celebration, let's go! Sing the song! Share New Birth, let's go.
Yeah.
One more time, sing it.
She said, come over here, I got something to say. You shouldn't be on TV acting that way. I said, whoa, you'd rather I be fake. Want me to act like I don't make mistakes. Sorry, ma'am, I ain't come that way. I gotta keep
2021, we doing things different. Let's go.
Your attitude is worse than mine. And you can be a little bit more kind. And if you won't vote, come to your church. We all gotta do some work. So be like Jesus.
Be like Jesus. Big shout out, Dr. Bryant, New Birth, let's go!
Everybody looking like there he is. They wanna remind you of what you did. Don't know why some people do won't forget. And some folks just won't let you live. Oh, how quick they forget what they did. Don't even remember who they did it with.
One more time.
Be like Jesus. Be like him.
We welcome you to New Birth. It's time to celebrate Jesus for all that he's done. All through 2020. We're about to cross over. But let's just celebrate God for his goodness, his kindness, his mercy, and his grace. I need you to like, I need you to comment, I need you to share. Let's worship Jesus together, because he's been better than good. Come on, let's worship.
I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises should continually be in my mouth. No matter what I see or how I feel, as long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord. As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord.
Everybody, come on, say it.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Come on, join us and sing it. Come on. Shall continually be. No matter what I see.
No matter what I see or how I feel.
As long as I'm breathing, come on, say it.
As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing, I'll bless the Lord.
Everybody lift it.
As long as I'm breathing, oh yes, I'm breathing.
Let's go, come on. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Everybody, come on.
Oh, magnify the Lord.
Let us exalt his name together.
Bless the Lord at all times.
off that couch. Get up off that bed. Put that car in park, pull on the side of the road. And just start praising. Just give him a praise. Cause he deserves your praise. He deserves your praise.
He deserves my praise.
He deserves my praise.
He deserves my praise.
You deserve my praise.
You deserve my praise.
You deserve a praise.
You deserve my praise.
You deserve a hallelujah.
You deserve my praise.
Cause you've been so good.
You deserve my praise.
You've been so good.
You deserve my praise.
Hey, 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 hey.
He's been better than good. After all that we've been through, we still got a reason to celebrate. Still got a reason to dance. Still got a reason to shout. And a reason to give God glory. This is the day the Lord has made, and we are glad and we rejoice in it. Look back over 2020, and you ought to declare right now, he's been better to me than I've been to myself. Come on. He's been better than good.
Better than good to me.
Better than good.
Better than good.
Death, all of the incidents, all of the accidents, he's still been better than good. I'm telling you, on this, the last day of the year, I still got a reason to clap my hands. I still got a reason to pat my feet. And I still got a reason to shout with joy. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Don't you dare let me do it by myself. This is our midday worship. I want you to do me a favor. Ain't no party like a new birth party, because a new birth party just don't stop. I want you to tag somebody. I want you to text somebody. I want you to tell somebody. Come on, let's have a day party. That's what we're doing. We couldn't wait till tonight, and so we wanted to do it today. Don't you have a testimony, something that you want to share off of your heart? When you look at April, look at October, look at August, didn't God do anything that's worthy of praise? I want you right where you are, just drop your testimony right there. I don't care how long it takes, how many lines it is. I want you to type, I was in the hospital. I was in a car accident. I lost my job, but he made a way for me. I want you to give that testimony. I'm believing somebody is going to be equipped. Somebody's going to be strengthened. Somebody's going to be reinvigorated, because we are, in fact, strengthened because of somebody else's testimony. I'm excited. I'm telling you, I'm bursting at the seams for what God is going to do today. In just a few moments, our guest Isaac Correa is going to be sharing. Tonight, you don't want to miss it. My baby sister Kiara Shield is going to be here. It's going to be an amazing time. But I got to tell you, all through 2020, guess what? The Holy Spirit has been here. And I'm so grateful that I can find the footsteps of the Father. As I look over the last 12 months, I can see his fingerprints of where it is that he left droplets of mercy and grace and love for all of us. 'Tis the season to be excited. I'm so excited and I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose my mind. And guess what? I think I like it. I'm going to give God a seed right now before I go into the new year. I'm going to thank him for what he has done this year. This is what I want you to do. Grab your phone. Right below me are the prompts by which you can give. If God's been a blessing to you every week this year, I want you to get a seed of $52 in your hand. I want you to get it in your possession. Even if you got to mail it, I want you to get yourself together. Those of you that can and will, through Giblify, Push to Pay, a text to give, and even on our own secure website at newbirth.org, I want you to give a gift of $52. Because God, I owe you thanksgiving, and turkey stuffing and cranberry sauce just won't do it. I've got to give a sacrifice of praise. Can you imagine that over the last couple of weeks, the U.S. Senate has been arguing about how much you deserve in the middle of a crisis. I'm telling you even right now that there is an instance in scripture where the angel said, we heard your prayer the first time, but there was warfare in heaven trying to block the answer to your prayer. I'm telling you, there is no traffic jam. There is no delay. There is no obstruction. God is going to get the glory out of your life. Every bill is going to be paid. Every need is going to be met. Every expectation is going to be fulfilled. I want you to come on in this giving space. Give and share your seed of 52 even right now. Every person that can, every person that will, I want you to have that seed in your possession. I'm expecting great things. That's what I'm doing. I am expecting great things, and I'm believing that it's going to happen for you. Allow me a moment of personal privilege as pastor just to express my heartfelt appreciation for all of you who have walked with the New Birth through this whole pandemic, for the 2,000 of you who have joined in the middle of the pandemic, for every seed you have sown, for every sacrifice you have made, for every Sunday, for every Tuesday, for every midday motivation. I want to appreciate you for seeing the vision, for following it through, and believing that New Birth was the place, not only where you were planted, but that you're going to bloom and you're going to blossom. God is going to get the glory. When you will consider that this year we have fed a 500,000 people in the middle of a crisis, that this year, while it is that hospitals were overrun and clinics were closed and millions were absent of affordable health care, I'm grateful that we were able to do free testing right on our campus. For the last couple of weeks, I have been working tirelessly trying to get out the vote. This is our last ditch effort. I don't want you to miss it on January the 5th. Two senators are going to be elected from the great state of Georgia. If you've got relatives in this state, you've got friends, please call them, text them, nudge them to remind them that they have got to go and vote. All of the nation is looking at Georgia, and I'm believing that history is going to be made. I don't know whether you can tell it or not, but I can't wait for this year to be over. And not only can I not wait for this year to be over, but I cannot wait for the new year to start. It is so much that God has poured in us that we couldn't just have one service. We had to have two. And I want you to celebrate with us, not just in this one, but even the one on tonight. It's going to be absolutely amazing. I want you to stay tuned because I want you to see how God has blessed us through this entire year to show that there's been miracles, there's been signs, there's been wonders, and guess what? There have been testimonies. Let's see what God has done in New Birth in 2020.
The most human trait is to want to know why. And in a year that tested everyone around the world, why was searched more than ever.
The spread of the coronavirus has passed a significant milestone.
And while we didn't find all the answers, we kept asking. Some questions inspired joy. Others, excitement.
Life in the bubble.
Yes.
Inami?
Yes.
Inami?
Yes.
I don't know what an improper fraction is.
Teachers should make $1 billion.
We found toilet tissue, y'all.
Oh my God.
Put it on there and start it up for me.
What are y'all doing? Yeah! It's still March. How many days in March?
At New Birth, before transition takes place, we're usually excited and eager, earnestly devoting ourselves to the things of the norm, whether that be yearly revivals, weekly worship services, restoration or self-improvement in our lives, or dedication to the things of God. In the middle of all of these norms, every one of us experienced some difficult changes in the year 2020. There were plenty of wins for our community. Through our medical debt relief initiative, we were able to ease the lives of many by assisting with paying $1.3 million in unpaid medical bills for the citizens of DeKalb County. In the spirit of maintaining health and wellness, we also saw the groundbreaking of the Garden of Eden, our very own garden where we harvest fruit and vegetables in our own backyard. Pastor Bryant gave us the blueprint for hope in a sermon series entitled, How to Prosper in a Pandemic. Or what about his sermon series, A Midwife Crisis, or all of the other inspirational messages we received that sustained us during 2020? What about the revivals that we had, which took us from glory to glory, the pandemic to pandemonium revival, or the vaccination revival curing stagnation? There was enough word in 2020 to make sure we kept on keeping on. What about the things we did as a response to that good word? New Birth opened a medical retreat center for frontline medical workers in partnership with the Allen Institute, American Express, and Hilton Hotels. By the end of the year, we saw the expansion of the King's Table Ministry and the partnership with World Vision. World Vision provided over $2.5 million worth of fresh food boxes, which were shared with other churches that covered the Southeast region of the United States of America. Leading up to this year's vote, we saw an increase in protest and social unrest. Racial injustice was at the top of our dialogue as we continued to champion the names and seek justice for the likes of Sandra Bland, Trayvon Martin, Mike Brown, and George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, Rayshard Brooks, and others. All of their names continue to stay top of mind as we go back to the polls in Georgia on January 5th.
Some questions made us cry.
You know, we've been through our ups and been through our downs. I think the most important part is that we all stay together throughout. I love you guys.
Some made us worry about this spinning rock we call home.
Fires were detected in the Amazon rainforest.
Why were so many lives lost?
Almost 1.5 million people have now died of COVID-19 worldwide.
Why are we still asking the same questions?
George Floyd repeatedly told the officers that he could not breathe.
So why do we still have strength to continue?
I believe in your power. I believe in our power.
Chants of Black Lives Matter echoed from thousands of protesters in cities around the world.
Why are we not defeated?
We have made too much progress, and we are not going back. We're going forward.
Planes are starting to arrive in Beirut, full of international aid.
Firefighters from around the world arriving in California.
There are over 100 coronavirus vaccines in development worldwide.
This is one of those times when people look out for one another and have each other's backs.
We kept going for those who showed us the way.
Think about how you would like the world to be for your daughters and granddaughters.
Remember, the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. Press on with pride and press on with purpose.
Why is it that this year showed its worst and we still found ways to triumph?
An incredible feat for Maya Gaviera.
Naomi Osaka, U.S. Open Championship.
Can't let Corona stop you. Can't let quarantine stop you.
So until we get to every answer,
celebrate God for what he has done for New Birth all year long. Do me a favor. I don't even know if I've gotten a chance to do this all year long. Can you do me a favor? Can you help me celebrate our wonderful pastor, Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant? I want you to put those hand clapping emojis on the screen. He's a great man of God, and he has served faithfully Sunday after Sunday all year long. We're grateful for our man of God. I need you to come on, talk on the screen. Talk on the screen for me. It is an honor and a privilege to introduce my brother. We've been friends for over 20 years, and he is here to celebrate God with us. A Stella Award winner, an amazing singer. He started with John P. Key, Men of Standard. Now he's an artist all of his own. I want you to do me a favor. Help me welcome to New Birth, Isaac Curry. Come on, help me celebrate.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Listen, welcome to New Birth. The day party is going down. Before I minister, can we give God praise for one of the greatest men of God I know? Any man who can change two states in a matter of a culture is amazing. Dr. Jamal Bryant, can you give God praise for him? He's amazing. He's my friend, and I thank God for New Birth. How many know that God is worthy of all the praise, all the honor, and all of the glory? We're gonna raise this praise today. Let's worship him. Hallelujah. I could never praise you enough. You knew my life, but you still gave me love. And when everybody walked away, you held my hand and took me just as I am. Yeah. The King who had set you free. Yeah. Pray that he listens to our hearts as we sing, worthy. Come on, raise that praise if you know he's worthy. Worthy is the King, so we praise. Yeah, the name that's above everything. Lord, you are worthy. Oh, yes, you are worthy. The King, so we praise the name that's above everything. Yeah. From the rising of the sun, before the setting, we overcome everything that had us bound. Oh, what a blessing to freely bow. What do you say? The King who has set you free. Yeah. And we pray that he listens to our hearts as we sing. Somebody help me say, worthy. Yeah. Yes, you are. Jesus is the King. Yeah. So we praise the name. That's above everything. Help me sing, worthy, yeah. I know you're at home, but you know he's worthy. Yeah. He's the King, so we praise the name. The name that's above everything. This is my favorite part. They thought I was worthless. Hey. But you thought I was worth that. Yeah. Though I don't deserve it, a love that's so worthless. Oh, they thought
I was worthless.
That's what they thought about me.
You thought I was worthless.
But you shed your blood for me.
Though I'm undeserving.
And though I'm undeserving. They did.
You thought I was worthy.
But God said, no, you're my child now. And though I'm undeserving
of a love that's
so perfect, oh,
they thought I was worthless.
That's what they thought about me, yeah.
I
thank God that you didn't throw me away. They thought I was worthless. Even in a pandemic, you covered me, Jesus.
They thought I was worthless.
But you thought I was worthless. Oh, I'm undeserving. Now take about 30 seconds to just raise your voice and give God your best praise. I don't care what it looks like. We know where 2020 was, but God is greater. We're going over into a new year, and that's enough to give him praise, because he's worthy. Let's raise it one more time. Come on. Worthy, worthy is the King, so we praise the name that's above everything. Oh, come on, open up your mouth. Come on, open up your mouth. It's okay. God, you're worthy of all the praise. You're worthy of all the glory. You're worthy of all the honor. God, I thank you for keeping me. I thank you for covering me, Jesus. You're worthy. Praise him. Praise him. Oh, praise him. Praise him. Help me they call his name. Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun, yeah, unto the going down. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Can you raise it at home? Whoa.
Praise him, no matter
going through, just praise. Why, church, why? Cause he knows your situation. Praise him in the middle. Oh, somebody clap your hands. Come on, church. Somebody do your dance. Believe it or not, God in heaven stuff praises the Lord's people. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm about to get ready to go, but one more time. Now clap your hands now. Hey, New Birth, I love y'all. Everybody in the world, I love y'all. Happy New Year. God bless you. Pastor Jamal, let's get it, man.
In the middle of it, there is only one Isaac Korea. I'm so appreciative for him, not just for him, but our own music ministry, for all of our musicians, for Jonathan Nelson, Tiffany Boone. Come on, let's give God glory. They have been leading us in worship all of 2020, and we are so thankful. They said, bring the minstrels, and we have the minstrels here, and I am so grateful for all of them. And all the more, I'm appreciative for all of you. Have you invited somebody to our day party? Did you tell anybody there's a party going on right now at New Birth? Come on, shame on you. This is the last dance of the year, and I want you to be a part of it. Real quick, would you run with me to the book of Acts, chapter 16? Acts chapter 16. And I only want to look at one verse, Acts 16, verse number 25. Acts 16, verse 25. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. I want to preach for a little while today using as a subject, I'll get over it. I'll get over it. Somebody ought to type that on the screen right now. Speak it to yourself. I will get over it. The older you get, the more you realize that it's not just a Christmas anthem. But all year long, you yearn for silent nights and holy nights, where you want all to be calm and all to be bright. At least that was the aspirational expectation for the citizens of Nashville, Tennessee, when they went to sleep on Christmas Eve. The heavenly dreams of gingerbread and gumdrops was violently disrupted at 5:30 a.m. Central Time when the sounds of gunfire went off downtown. A parked RV then started blaring an announcement to residents admonishing them to immediately evacuate because a bomb was about to detonate. A 15-minute countdown began to pursue that left 41 buildings disheveled in its wake. I gotta ask you a question. Don't you just wish that when explosions and disruptions came into your life, that they came with a warning to give you some time to get away from there, to separate yourself, to put some distance? This year has been a whole lot of explosions. No clue you would contract COVID. No clue that your hours would get cut. No clue that a cousin would succumb to cancer. No clue that you would be impacted by a car accident. You had no idea that your idea would be stolen. Had no sense that watching the news would be bad for your nerves. Couldn't believe that with all of the economic calamity that the IRS still wants their money. The mayor of Nashville, John Cooper, said in his initial press briefing, "The attack on our community was intended to create chaos and fear in a season of peace and hope. But the spirit of our city cannot be broken." I want you to just declare that over yourself. I cannot be broken. It's a whole lot going on with you, but I need your mind to be resolved. I need your spirit to be fixed. I cannot be broken. In spite of the shocks and surprises that unfurled this year, your spirit will not be shaken. You're not going to go down an emotional rabbit hole with no possibility of survival. The reality is that even mountains go through an aftershock. Right after a volcano erupts, the mountain needs a moment to adjust. No matter how strong you fancy yourself to be, the wave of all that you have been dealing with will inevitably crash onto the shores of your sensibilities. Psychological shock is when you experience a surge of strong emotions and a corresponding physical reaction. And it's all in response to an unexpected, stressful event. You have gone through shock in 2020. You didn't used to have migraines like this. You didn't used to be sleepy all the time. You didn't always find yourself irritable. You don't even know why. You walk around unknowingly with your hand clenched in a fist. Don't even know why it is that you've got to swallow hard and you sleep light. The impact of the shock is related to how close you are to the explosion. It hits different when it's just some random child on the news, as opposed to the child that you gave birth to. It's multiplied all the more when it's you personally in the briar patch. Your adrenaline accelerates, your chest tightens, your anger intensifies. You are screaming even when you are silent. Your mind is running while your body wants to collapse. It's the merry-go-round of fight, flight, or freeze. So many make wrong decisions out of desperation and out of depletion. You're not pouring out of an empty pitcher. You've been pouring out of a dirty one, contaminating the people who are close to you. And because of dehydration, they've got no better sense than to drink from your dirty cup. So every now and again, you've got to take time to decompress, not as punishment, but really out of therapy. You got to tell yourself, y'all, give me a minute before I go off. Y'all back up off me. For real, for real. I ain't got time to play right now. Your antics are irritating for me. I do not have the patience for your superficiality. I don't have time for grown folk acting like children. When you got so much going on where you don't know whether to cry, cuss, or pray. You're going through that whole adrenaline that's going on in your spirit, and you're saying to yourself, is this the end? Feel as if the sky is falling. The clouds are gathering. The forecast is dark. And yet you gotta trust God when God is saying absolutely nothing. And in spite of all of the reality, all of the facts, your faith keeps whimpering. You're going to get over this. You're better than this. You're stronger than this. And you can't believe it. And you're a person of faith. You're a person of conviction. You're a person that knows the word, but you're not even consolable for the bind that you're in. You talking yourself out of deliverance. Out of a miracle, out of a breakthrough, that you are second guessing the very presence of God. I can't even imagine what it was going through the minds of Paul and Silas when they're found in Acts chapter 16. I wish I could sit them down on the panoply of psychology. I wish I could get them to just stretch out on the brown couch in the therapist's office. What's going on in the mind of Paul and Silas is what's going on in the minds of millions of you who are logged in right now. They woke up on some nondescript morning, and the two of them came into agreement. Today, we're going to church just to pray. We're not going to preach. We don't have any solos. We're not coming for any community project. We are going to God's house to pray. And while they're on their way there, the Bible shares with us in Acts chapter 16 that some little girl keeps coming behind them, taunting them, saying disparaging things about them, trying to throw off their focus and their attention. But here's what I don't want you to miss. Come here. I don't want you to miss this. I need you to see all they are doing is trying to get close to God. And in their attempt to get close to God, here comes a distraction. Some of you don't even see what's happening here. Is that the person who is trying to distract them, trying to throw off their focus, who is hurling all kinds of insults at them, that person is not even their size. That person is not even their weight. These are two grown men. And the person who's trying to distract them is a girl. I need you to know this. I don't know where the 73 of you all are large right now who I'm preaching to. But I need to tell you, whoever's trying to distract you is not your size. Whoever's trying to pull you down is trying to pull you to their level. Whoever it is that's trying to mess you up, wish that they could be you. She's trying to do everything to throw them off. But I love the model of Paul and Silas. They never fight her. They never talk back. They never clap back. They never do a subtweet. What they do is what we've got to learn to do. Cast out that spirit. Whoever it is that is a saboteur to your success, whoever it is that is conspiring to bring confusion to your life, whoever it is that's trying to taint your character and trying to besmirch your personality, God says today, before you go in the new year, I break that spirit off of them. I'm thankful that God is getting ready to do something in the spirit and in the heart and in the mind of those who willfully don't want to see you succeed. Don't want to see you emerge. Don't want to see you rise. Don't want to see you manifest into who it is that you are called to be. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I cast out that spirit from them. thing that is troubling for me is that immediately that spirit is cast out. And that's the kind of faith you've got to exercise and exude. That whoever it is that was against me in 2020, that God is getting ready to sap their strength. He's getting ready to weaken their muscle. He's getting ready to break their influence. It's not always strangers. God's getting ready to turn the heart of somebody who was assigned to help you, but they refused to do so. A relative who was jealous and in competition. A friend who was two-faced. They like you as long as they're in your face. A saint who is praying against you, not in the language of heavenly tongues, but in the fluid tempo of satanic trances. God says, I am getting ready to undermine those who have been trying to undermine you. And immediately that spirit is cast out of her. And I would think that as soon as they cast out that spirit of that young girl, that immediately they're able to go through with their assignment. But they end up in jail. I'm going to ask you a question. Maybe you can't answer it, but I'll try to. What happens when you free other people, but you're in bondage? What happens when you help others, but you can't help yourself? What happens when you push people to progress, and yet you find your life stagnant? The Bible says that after they freed that girl of the spirit, they end up in prison. I got to ask you this question. Because when I read our text today, Acts chapter 16, verse number 25, and at midnight, Paul and Silas begin praising and worshiping God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Most of you who are reared in church, raised in church, you know this text. It's also familiar. At midnight, they begin giving God glory and doors open up. That's where we know the story to crescendo. But what I want to argue out loud for the moments that are least to me, I want to argue out loud is maybe you forgot. Then Paul and Silas woke up in the morning and said, we're going to prayer. They arrested by noon. And the question that I need you as critical thinkers to examine is, if they're arrested at noon, how come it took till midnight for them to worship? I know some of you all praise God all the time. I get it. I know some of y'all stay in the Holy of Holies. I know that your tongue is right on tap. I ain't preaching to you. Come back another time. I'm talking to those of you who know that sometimes it takes me a minute, that I got to let the shock wear off before it is that I can really get into my place of worship. And so I want to go through the afternoon with Paul and Silas to try to figure out what happened before midnight. Might I humbly suggest to you that about 4:30, Paul looks at his Apple Watch and says to Silas at 4:30, the question that you've raised many times in 2020, here's what Paul raised at 4:30. How am I anointed and in this? Have you ever been there? Well, you are anointed, but in the middle of the day, you had to second guess where you stand with God. Where you had to reevaluate everything that he told you in dreams and what you etched in the prayer journals. Have you ever had a 4:30 where you didn't even have the strength to pray? That you didn't feel compelled to read the word of God? How in the world am I his vessel? And I'm stuck in this.
6:30 comes. At 6:30, Silas hears footsteps coming down the hall. But the guard doesn't stop at their cell. The guard goes further down the block and says to one of the other prisoners, "You got a visitor downstairs." Silas at 6:30 is trying to figure out, "I prayed for all of these people. I preached to all these people. How come nobody has come to see about me?" Have you ever had a 6:30 experience where you can remember those who you called when they were in need? Those who you sent texts of encouragement when they had a rough time. Those you stood in the gap for, but you had a 6:30 moment where you realized nobody calling to check on me. Nobody praying for me. Nobody checking to see if I'm all right. Where you realize the liability of being strong is people can't handle your weak moment. 6:30, nobody comes. They've been there all afternoon. And now it's 8:30. At 8:30, they realize that the bail bondsman is getting ready to shut down. And no lawyer has showed up to defend them. At least my constitutional right ought to be assigned to defend me. Have you ever had an 8:30 moment when nobody will defend you even when they know your character? They will be fast to tell you what other people said, but they're slow to say what they said to defend your honor. You ought to be thankful right now that there are a legion of angels who are fighting on your defense, who are believing by faith that something great is going to happen for you. There's more for you than there are against you. You ain't never had an 8:30 moment. And now, friends, it's 10:30. They've been there all day and they do what people do. Paul looks at Silas. Silas looks at Paul. It's a 10:30 moment. And in that 10:30 moment, it's not written in Acts, but I want to tell you what Paul is thinking. Paul is thinking at 10:30, "I should have stayed with who I was with before you. God, help me in here. I didn't go through all of this until I connected with you." I'm telling you, you got to be careful of your 10:30 moments when you begin to reevaluate who is really there with you. When you second guess people's loyalty and love and commitment, you got to not forget, Paul, Silas is in it with you. I'm so thankful that there's somebody in it with you tonight. There's somebody in it with you today. You ain't in this thing by yourself. I need you to tag somebody real quick and just tell them, "I'm in it with you. I ain't going to let you go through this by yourself. I'm going to stick in here with you. If two or three are gathered together in my name, there I'll be also." It's now 11:30. It's 11:30 and they're walking around and they're trying to figure out, what do we do? I'm in this jail. Hallelujah. There's no vodka for me to drink. It's 11:30. I wish I could. I can't get my hands on no weed. It's 11:30. I got no lottery cards that I can play. It's 11:30. There are no ropes for me to hang myself. It's 11:30. What am I going to do? Have you had an 11:30 moment where you begin to entertain the stuff you used to do when you were weak? An 11:30 moment when you used to lean on your crutch and lean on the thing that was easy and comfortable and convenient for you. Have you had an 11:30 moment? They finally let the shock wear off. That nobody is coming to see me. Nobody is going to defend me. I'm in here by myself with somebody I'm not sure I should be with. And at midnight, God, help me in here. It says, I done tried everything else. But before I step into a new day, I got to pause right here and give him glory. Now, this ain't for phony saints. I'm giving him glory, and I hate where I am. I'm giving him glory, and I don't deserve this. I'm giving him glory, and I've been wrongfully accused. I'm giving him glory, and my name is dragged through the mud. But I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I got to give you this because I think you really miss what has happened. They're there all day and never pray. They're there all day and never read the word of God. But they said for 1 minute, hallelujah. Midnight is not 12:15. Midnight is not 10 after. Midnight is not a half past. But they said if I can just worship God for one sustained minute, I am believing a door is getting ready to open that's going to be better than the door I walked in on. I don't know how you feel about it, but can you find one virtual praise partner? Would you just begin to give God glory? I'm going to get over this. I'm upset. I'm depressed. I'm unhappy. I'm frustrated. I'm lonely, I'm unemployed, I've been sabotaged, I've been lied on, I've been talked about, I've been mistreated, but I will get over this. If it's the last thing I do, I will give him praise. I will magnify him. I will bless his holy name. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, he is worthy. Hallelujah. He's worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah. I feel glory now. He's worthy. And I will get over it. Even at the risk of looking crazy, would you just say it to yourself? I will get over this. I will get over this. It may take me a minute, but I will get over this. I don't even see it, but I will get over this. I want you to lift that hand right where you are. I'm going to get over this, I'm telling you. I don't know the last time I slept through the night, but I will get over it. I'm somewhere between not eating and overeating. But I will get over it. I vacillate between wanting to be around people and being by myself. But I will get over it. I'm somewhere in the pendulum of praying and fasting and giving God the silent treatment. But I will get over it. I'm not telling you you're going to be a millionaire. I'm not telling you your name is going to be in lights or your account is going to be verified. All I'm telling you is that you're getting ready to come out of this stronger than you were before it. You're going to bend under life's pressures, but you are not going to break. The prophetic word that God has for your life going into 21, there is nothing you can't come back from. There's nothing in this earth that has more power than the destiny over your life. I will get over this. I want you to lay hands on yourself. I want to pray for you. I'm believing God for you. It took a minute for you to get to this moment, but God had to purge you with hyssop. He had to squeeze you out of you. He had to reorientate your expectation. Yes, the friends of Job asked him, do you think the God you serve can only bless? You don't know that he reigns on the just and the unjust. I don't know where you are, but I feel your spirit crying on the other side of that screen. You will get over this. I'm telling you, you had to bury some relatives this year. You had to deal with some legal things this year. You had to downsize without downgrading. You had to make some adjustments that you didn't see coming. But I swear to God, you're going to get over this. I want you to lay hands on your heart, please. I want to pray that God will perform open heart surgery on your life, on your spirit, on your expectation, hear this, on your faith, that you ain't going to have to wait till midnight to pray. That prayer is not going to be your last resort. That worship will not be on a shelf in case of emergency. But all 21, I want worship to be your go-to. I don't wait for everything else to fail. But even if I got to make the side of my bed the altar, even if I got to pull over in my car and give God worship, I will. Watch me. I will get over this. Lord, I pray for my friend. I pray for your child, your servant. I pray for that mom, that dad, that husband, that wife, that brother, that coworker, that colleague. I pray for that one who's bringing in the new year alone. I pray for the one who is celebrating with people that they question. I pray for those who have had nobody check on them. I pray for those who feel like they always have to defend themselves. I pray for those who are second guessing their assignment and the oil on their life. God, I pray you open doors for them. Open doors for them because of their worship. It's not too late. Open doors for them, but not just them, like you did for Paul and Silas. Open doors for every person connected to them, that it shall come to pass. And God, we give you glory, we give you praise, we give you thanksgiving. Come on, let's celebrate them now. Only clap if you believe you're gonna get over it. Only clap if you believe a door is gonna open for you. Only celebrate them if you believe it's not too late. It's gonna work in my favor. Listen to me. It's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
It's not too late for you to get to God. Paul and Silas were arrested in the middle of the afternoon, but they didn't worship till midnight. You were at the midnight of your own life. And I want you to get saved today. I want you to give your life over to God. I want you to get connected to this church called New Birth. I'm telling you, you are aligned with a company of believers who have had some 4:30 moments, some 6:30 experiences, some 10:30 crises. But at midnight, we came out of it. I want to be your pastor. I want New Birth to be your church. I want Jesus to be your Lord. I want heaven to be your home. If you can hear my voice and your soul resonates with what it is that I suggest, I don't want you to delay. I don't want you to hesitate. I don't want you to deliberate. I want you to come while you still have time. I need you to give it all over to our God. Let me ask all of you, if we can, I want us to give a sizable, a substantive, and a significant seed over to our God. I'm going to challenge 52 of you to give a seed of 365. I want 52 of you to give a seed of $365. 52 of you, I need you to do that. Why? Because I am believing every day in 2021, a door is going to be open. I am believing, hear this, that every day God is going to manifest some sign of what he has promised. 52 of you, I want you to give a seed of $365. I want 365 of you to give a seed of 52. You're saying, Pastor, I'm believing that every week God is going to do it. That 7 days will not pass without me seeing a door open, without God, here it is, not waiting till midnight to deliver me, but in the middle of the day. I want God to not wait for Sundays for my breakthrough, but even on a Thursday, even on a Friday, even on a Wednesday, I want God to do it for me. It is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do it for you. That's the good news of the harmony that you hear under me. It won't always be like this. Come on, God is going to perfect it.
The Lord will perfect that concerning.
Come on, let's sing it together. Sooner or later.
Sooner or later.
It's going to work in my favor. Come on, it's turning around.
Turning around.
It's turning around.
In your living room, in your bedroom. Come on, would you just turn around right there? It won't always.
It won't always be like this.
Lord,
the Lord will perfect that concerning me.
Say it in your home sooner or later.
Sooner.
To lift up both of your hands, I want to speak blessing and benediction over your life for 2021. I'm going to speak blessing and benediction over your life. 21 is the age that you are legal. 21 is the age that you are legal. I want you to receive this blessing that God deposited in me even while I stand in this moment. I speak over every listening ear that for the year of 2021, every month you will have a miracle. 2021, every month you will have a miracle. Every week you will be a witness to what God is able to do. Every day you will experience deliverance and divine provision. Every hour, the Holy Spirit will hover around your home. Every second, you will be closer to your success. And I declare it to be so. In Jesus' name, amen. Your pastor loved you. Happy New Year. The best is yet to come.
You're gonna see miracles. You're gonna see it. You're gonna see.
You're gonna see a miracle.
You're gonna see miracles. You're gonna see. You're gonna see.
You're gonna see miracles.
Gonna see miracles. You're gonna see. You're gonna see.
Prophesy.